make sure that you, the public, lose your freedom of speech.
He's a guy that we kind of started off playing together. We had a group called the Young Philadelphians. We did that project. We did some things, some recordings together with James Carter, mm-hmm. saxophonist. We did a lot of shows together in Europe, a lot of shows together in New York. He played with me with my band called Brother Zone. Mm-hmm. Early on, and then we also had a little group with John Zorn. So yeah. I was kind of like brought into that whole New York downtown scene.
Yeah.
I was from Philadelphia, but they kind of brought me into that world with them to kind of help define the sound.
Right.
It was always like Bill Frisell and Elias Sharp,
right.
And John Zorn and Mark Rebo,
right.
and you know that whole
clique,
Anton Fear, Otto Lindsay,
you know.
From the Golden Palominos,
yeah.
Bill Laswell, so early on, so I was playing with Ornette, so you know. They were very interested in that concept, and then I was a young guy like them, and you know, playing electric bass. So they said, "Oh, let's include him into our little world here." So, and it was funny too because other musicians that I knew always used to look at me. I didn't know that, but now in retrospect, I'm seeing how they used to look at me in a certain kind of way because. They were not involved in that scene.
Yeah.
It's because I was involved in their scene and that scene also. Mm-hmm. So, you know, it was kind of an interesting way that they used to, you know, kind of observe me. You know, they really didn't know if I was so-called into black music, mm-hmm. black improvisational music, or the more wider punk, mm-hmm. rock, kind of art scene, blah,
yeah.
blah, blah, you know,
yeah,
that whole
yeah.
New York
right.
thing.
Right.
But I just looked at it all and just navigated myself through all of that stuff and just did everything that I wanted to do.
Yeah. I'm gonna go to the bathroom.